Students, today we will discuss about angular dispersion. If we have a prism like so, and a white light passes through the prism, it splits into constituent colors. Now, we know that we get a band of 7 colors starting from V to R. V, I, B, G, Y, O, R. Dim gear, this is. This is what you get. 7 colors. This is dispersion. Now, what is angular dispersion? Means by what angle from the original direction? This was the original direction of white light. With respect to this original line, by what angle the different rays are turned or bent when it passes through the prism and then it comes out? So, in its final journey of the different colors, when they are separated within the prism and afterwards when it comes out in air. So, starting from this air, when it comes out from the same medium air, by what angle the different colors are bent or deviated from their initial direction? This is the angle of deviation of individual colors. This angle This is the angle of deviation for the red color. Angle of deviation. This is the angle of deviation for violet colors. These are the two extreme colors. These are the two extreme colors. Why extremes? Because they are the last colors. Beyond this, beyond red, there is nothing, or below violet, there is nothing. Extreme colors. The whole spectrum of 7 colors is bounded between those two extreme colors, violet and red. In between, you'll find other colors. Yellow color is taken as the mean color of this. Yellow color is taken as the mean color. So, which one is the mean color? This, I'll use a red one, but then. Suppose this is yellow color. Why? This yellow color. This yellow color is called the mean color of this white light. So, this angle, this ray is deviated from its normal direction, original direction, by this angle. So, therefore, this is called angle of deviation for yellow color. Now, what is angular dispersion? These are the deviations from original direction, the angle of deviations. That is the angle of deviation. Then, what is angular dispersion is the angle of through which those 7 colors spread out. With what angle they spread out? With this angle they spread out. You can see here, they spread out in this angle only. This angle, you can see here. So, this is the angle. If I draw it like that, so it's something like that. This is your red and this is violet. So, this is the region where rays are spread. What is this angle? This angle through which the colors are spreading are angle is called angular dispersion. So, angular dispersion is the angle of spreading of colors which make this light. So, this light is made up of 7 colors. So, these 7 colors are spreading in this region and this angle. So, this angle is called angular dispersion. So, It is the difference. So how to get this angle? How to get this angle? This total angle minus this angle. Total angle minus this angle is this angle. So this angle minus this angle is this angle. So what are the two angles we are subtracting? Violet and red, extreme colors. Difference between for extreme colors, for extreme colors. So basically what happened? This is the thing. This is the original direction. Of the ray. This is the red and this is the violet color. This bends by this angle, this bends by this angle, gets deviated by this angle. Now this angle is called angular dispersion. So obviously this angle is delta V, this angle is delta R. So therefore angular dispersion is delta V minus delta R. Now, for a thin prism, delta is A into mu minus 1. Delta is always delta minimum, and always, so delta, what to write? If delta is always delta minimum, there is no need to write delta, there is no need to write m, because always it is minimum, so there is no need to write this subscript n. So you just drop it, only write delta. So delta is A into mu minus 1, where this delta is actually delta minimum. Now for different colors you have delta different. Why different? Because A is not different. The angle of the prism that is here, this is same for all the colors, because by different colors passing through the prism, A is not going to change. So for all the colors V to R, this A is same. Then why delta is different? Because delta is A times mu minus 1, A is constant, 1 is constant, that means this mu is different. The refractive index for different color is different when it passes through a prism. Okay, so that we will note first. There is a very important point, that is the mu, that is refractive index for different color is different. So what will do? We will write for violet, violet color, write V here, V mu V here, for red R here, mu R here, like that. So what you will have for a thin prism, this formula can be used, and for this situation of three different colors I will consider, the L1A being the main color of two extreme colors. Now the mu for different color is different, so therefore I will write delta V for violet color as A into mu V minus 1. This is for violet color. Similarly, mu R is A into red color, mu 1. So these are the refractive indexes for different colors, and these are the deviations, corresponding deviations, angle of deviation, which is obviously minimum for thin prism. Okay, now angular dispersion is delta V minus delta R. So I will put delta V as this and delta R as this here. What will get? This will cancel out. So this is the angle of this is the angular dispersion which I have written in terms of the refractive index. We have written in terms of refractive index. So this is obviously, let me remind you that this is useful for a thin prism. This is valid only for thin prism. Only for thin prism. Okay. Now, what are the factors on which this angular dispersion depends? As the formula suggests, that the angular dispersion is delta V minus delta R, which is in terms of refractive index of different pellets, it is so therefore this angular dispersion depends on two factors. One is A, the other one is depends on angle of prism and refractive index. So these are the two factors on which it depends. One is depends upon A and depends upon this. These are the two factors on depends. Okay. Now, if you think of the unit of this angular dispersion, it should be in radian or degree. In SI system, it is radian. Mostly we are using in radian, and obviously it has no dimension.